Assalamu alaikum. I first want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the opportunity to speak today, and of course the MCC community for providing a platform for the all too often silenced voices of today. My Lord, expand for me my breast with assurance, and ease for me my task, and untie the knot from my tongue, that they may understand my speech. Inshallah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My name is Amira Nicole. I'm a Palestinian American with family that still lives and owns land in the West Bank. Being born in America, I was born into the ideals of this country. Ideals spoon-fed to us from a young age, that we should be proud to be an American, where the Bill of Rights protects freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom of assembly, and the freedom to petition. How cruel to be taught to empower these ideals, to be grateful of them, only to realize too quickly that these basic human rights don't apply to me because of my ethnicity and faith. Some of my earliest memories, I like to think that they're from my core memories, are from my summers in Palestine. My mother passed away, Allah irhamha, when I was very young. So my aunts and uncles took me in and treated me as their own. I was and am truly blessed to have the connection and safety of a community that looks out for their youth. I couldn't have been more than 5 years old at the time, but I still remember the smell of the fresh baked bread in the kishuk, the feeling of the sun while running through the olive trees on my family's land, and the taste of fresh figs and grapes freshly plucked off the branches of a tree. The sweetest you could taste. That day, my aunt was taking me to a local city to do some shopping. I was always very excited to go out and explore. I could never turn my brain off, needing to see, hear, and experience everything around me. As we were walking down the street in this nearby city, things quickly took a turn. I heard screams, dust, and smoke everywhere. I saw IDF soldiers beating on men, tying them together in long lines along the side of the road. I heard the sound of a man yelling, then being dragged away by a soldier to an alleyway where I heard shots, then silence. They threw tear gas at us. My aunt grabbed me by the hand and ran for the city limits. A man with a truck was there telling everyone he could see, "Just get in, just get in." So we all crammed ourselves into the back of his truck as he sped away from all the violence. I was 5 years old at the time. I later learned that this, I'm pregnant, so I'm a little emotional at times. Alhamdulillah. I later learned that this was part of the first Intifada, when Palestinians who had had enough of the apartheid regime, the military occupation, started to protest. That protesting was met with violence, cruelty, and death. In my later visits, I realized how oppressive it truly was. I felt the discrimination of being Palestinian, being held for hours on end every time I tried to enter my country. When I was 16 years old, I traveled alone to visit my aunts and uncles. Israel held me for 8 hours with rifles in hand, interrogating me without just reason. I still believe this is a tactic that they use for on many of us to intimidate us and scare us from ever returning. Simple visits to the Holy Land, just a short drive away from my village, maybe 15 minutes, were made almost impossible for many members of my family. And for me, with an American passport, it was still extremely difficult. Unable to pray in Al-Aqsa Masjid and only being 15 minutes away, can you imagine? I realized quickly that the wall that supposedly separates Israel from Palestine was separating Palestinians themselves from neighboring Palestinian villages and from their own land. For example, we had wanted to go to a bakery in a neighboring village. We couldn't because of the checkpoints. There are no other words to describe it. It is a civilian prison. My family this year could not even go to their own land to harvest the almost 5,000 olive trees, which used to be much more, but in recent years, the Israeli settlers, the illegal Israeli settlers, and the IDF burned and tore down over 1,400 trees. The settlers have now begun building homes on the mountaintops surrounding the smaller villages. And they've been armed with weaponry. When I left that trip, I had to go back through Israel to get to the main airport. Seeing the contrasting differences in resources, amenities, and rights was very hard to witness. I went more than 6 hours earlier for my flight. I almost missed it due to the interrogations. Again, I was 16 years old at the time. In hindsight, I was protected. My friend's son, years later at 16 years old, was beaten merciless and held without legal or parental aid. His younger cousin murdered by his legal settlers in the West Bank. Shortly after returning to the States that summer, I was the target of a hate crime. A woman saw me on a plane wearing a headscarf, and she started screaming hysterically that I was a terrorist and that I was going to bomb and destroy the plane. She kept spewing out such hatred. When the flight attendants finally were able to calm her, they spent the entire flight looking at me. One man out of over 100 people present, only one man, I think he was of Asian descent, had the strength to say something against that woman. I had to endure the rest of the flight hearing her. Thank you so much. Instill hate in her kids. She had two young kids next to her. And she would point out the window loud enough so that I could hear. Look, that's where she's hiding all of the bombs and ammunition. Don't tell her where you live or she's going to come and kill you in the night. I again felt powerless, voiceless, so young but unable to explain to the world what I had witnessed and seen. As our beloved religion teaches us, Iqra, read. So I turned to reading and then to writing. I wrote some of what I had experienced down and shared it with my high school newspaper. It caught attention and quickly. Israeli students were allowed to write rebuttals to one of my pieces, flooding the paper with their narrative. When I wrote my response, I wasn't told till it was too late, but the administration pulled the piece the night before it was scheduled to be printed, censored again. I recently reached out to my aunt to ask her about the more recent accounts of what is happening. It was just simply too painful for her to share. She did manage to tell me about the destroyed trees, the stolen land from our village, and all around as these legal settlers get closer and closer to our homes. She, unfortunately, has been banned from ever going back to the land and the home that she still owns. The injustices are sometimes too numerous to recount. Too often, the voices of those being oppressed and mistreated are censored by those who are, by those whose voices are louder and more aggressive than our own. The irony. That's why we must have the strength and knowledge to speak louder. Our beloved Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, known for his kindness and beautiful character, taught us the importance of speaking and advocating for those being mistreated. I pray we can all stand on the right side of history and stand before Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala with a sound heart that we did what we could. Just remember, I'm one story of millions. Don't let the media continue to vilify, censor, and dehumanize us just to set their own agenda. I wanted to end with a poem that I had written while I was in college many years ago. Many years later, it still holds relevant. It's called Searching for Humanity. One day I woke up to crying, running down his face were tears. My heart ached as I looked at him and knew I could not wash away his fears. His little body endured so much, yet his years remained so few. And the justice that he deserves is long overdue. When will the world open up its eyes and see all this inhumanity? No, instead it just looks down upon them with such insensitivity. Palestine is and was the home buried deep within our hearts, the blood that flows to our souls, giving life to all our parts. Palestine is the birthplace of our sisters and our brothers, and the burial place of even more of our fathers and our mothers. So strong Palestine and its people have withheld all the fury and the guns. Yet time and time again, it is Israel that receives international excessive funds. Will you let me take you on a journey? Will you let me take you by the hand? then maybe through the eyes of another, you will begin to understand. Is apartheid too strong a word to make you see what's true? Can I believe that you will try to see things from another point of view? The year was 1948, when so many lost their lives, when the bonds that fell upon them were as many as a swarm of fireflies. Some who were kept say it was as if the stars were falling from the skies, and still at night they awake to hearing all those heart-wrenching cries. Dar es Salaam was but one of the many cities massacred that year. Before nightfall, over 250 people were systematically murdered as the land was washed with children's tears. The death toll has been so vast that through my breath it's difficult to speak. And yet, in 2023, it still has not yet reached its peak. Now, don't even get me started on Hafrada, the segregation wall that rises as a prison over 8 meters tall. In comparison, it makes the Berlin Wall look like nothing but a joke, dividing people from their land, dividing them from their common folk. So why are there so many people misguided, or has the whole world just gone blind? Is it just because it's not directly affecting what they believe is their own kind? We are all brothers and sisters in the fight for the rights of those who cannot speak out. And so I leave you with just one last thing, the most important thing without a doubt, that the greatest enemy of knowledge is not ignorance itself. It is the illusion of knowledge, the misconceptions of one's true self. Please continue to make dua for the Palestinians in Gaza and the West Bank, and all those being oppressed around the world. If I said anything of benefit, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I said anything that was incorrect, it is all from me. Barakallahu fikum for staying and listening to all of that, inshallah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inshallah, we're going to read dua al-Nasiri with intention, inshallah, of al-Nasr and al-Faraj, inshallah, to our brothers and sisters in Palestine. يا من إلى رحمته المفر ومن إليه يلجأ المضطر ويا قريب العفو يا مولاه ويا مغيث كل من دعاه بك استغاثنا يا مغيث الضعفاء فحسبنا يا ربي أنت وكفى فلا أجل من عظيم قدرتك ولا أعز من عزيز سطوتك لعز ملكك الملوك تخضع تخفض قدر من تشاء وترفع والأمر كله إليك رده وبيديك حله وعقده وقد رفعنا أمرنا إليك وقد شكونا ضعفنا عليك فارحمنا يا من لا يزال عليما بضعفنا ولا يزال رحيما انظر إلى ما مسنا من الورى فحالنا من بينهم كما ترى قد قل جمعنا وقل وفرنا وانحط ما بين الجموع قدرنا واستضعفونا شوكة وشدة واستنقصونا عدة وعدة فنحن يا من ملكه لا يسلب لذنا بجاهك الذي لا يغلب إليك يا غوث الفقير نستند عليك يا كف الضعيف نعتمد أنت الذي ندعو لكشف الغمرات أنت الذي نرجو لدافع الحصارات أنت العناية التي لا نرتجي حماية من غير بابها تجي أنت الذي نسعى بباب فضله أكرم من أغنى بفائض نيله
أنت الذي تهدي إذا ضللنا، أنت الذي تفو إذا زللنا، وسعت كل ما خلقت علما ورأفة ورحمة وحلما، وليس منا في الوجود أحقر ولا لما عندك منا أفقر. يا واسع الإحسان يا من خيره عم الورى ولا ينادى غيره، يا منقذ الغرق ويا حنان، يا منجي الهلك ويا منان، ضاق النطاق يا سميع يا مجيب، عز الدواء يا سريع يا قريب. وقد مددنا ربنا الأكفى، ومنك ربنا رجاؤنا اللطفى، فالطف بنا بما به قضيت، ورضنا بما به رضيت، وأبدل اللهم حال العسر باليسر، وامددنا بريح النصر، واجعل لنا على البغاة الغلبة، واقصر أذى الشر على من طلبه، واجعل لهم على البغاة الغلبة، واقصر أذى الشر على من طلبه، واجعل لهم على البغاة الغلبة، واقصر أذى الشر على من طلبه، واقهر عداهم يا عزيز قهرا، يفصم حبلهم ويصمي الظهر، واعكس مرادهم وخيب سعمهم، واهزم جيوشهم وأفسد رأيهم، وعجل لهم فيهم نقمتك، فإنهم لا يعجزون قدرتك. يا ربي يا ربي بحبل عصمتك قد اعتصمنا، وبعز نصرتك فكلنا، ولا تكون علينا ولا تكن طرفة إلينا، فما أطاقنا قوة للدافع، ولا استطعنا حيلة للنفع، وما قصدنا غير بابك الكريم، وما رجونا غير فضلك العميم، فما رجت من خيرك الظنون، بنفس ما تقول كن يكون. يا ربي يا ربي بك التوصل، لما لديك وبك التوسل، يا ربي أنت ركننا الرفيع، يا ربي أنت حصننا المنيع، يا ربي يا ربي أنيلنا الأمنى إذا ارتحلنا وإذا أقمنا، يا ربي واحفظ زرعنا وضرعنا، واحفظ تجارنا ووفر جمعنا، واجعل بلادنا بلاد الدين، وراحة المحتاج والمسكين، واجعل لها بين البلاد صولة، وحرمة ومنعة ودولة، واجعل من السر المصون عزها، واجعل من الستر الجميل حرزها، واجعل بصاد وبقاف وبنون ألف حجاب من ورائها يكون، بجاه نور وجهك الكريم، وجاه سر ملكك العظيم، وجهنا إله إلا الله وجه خير الخلق يا رباه وجه ما به دعاك الأنبياء وجه ما به دعاك الأولياء وجه قدر القطب والأوتاد وجه حال الجرس والأفراد وجه الأخيار وجه النجبا وجاه الأبدان وجاه النقبا وجاه كل عبد وذاكر وجاه كل حميد وشاكر وجاه كل من رفعت قدره ممن سترت أو نشرت ذكره وجاه آيات الكتاب المحكم وجاه الاسم الأعظم المعظم يا ربي يا ربي وقفنا فقراء بين يديك ضعفاء حقراء وقد دعوناك دعاء من دعا ربا كريما لا يرد من سعى فاقبل دعانا بمحض الفضل فاقبل دعاءنا بمحض الفضل قبول من ألغى حساب العدل ومن علينا منة الكريم واعطف علينا عطفة الحليم وانشر علينا يا رحيم رحمتك وابسط علينا يا كريم نعمتك واخر لنا في سائر الأقوال واختر لنا في سائر الأفعال يا ربي واجعل دأبنا التمسك بالسنة الغراء والتنسك واحصر لنا أعراضنا المختلفة فيك وعرفنا تمام المعرفة واجمع لنا ما بين علم وعمل واصرف إلى دار البقاء من الأمل واجبنا يا ربي ناج السعداء واختم لنا يا ربي خاتم الشهداء واجعل بنينا فضلاء صلحاء وعلماء عاملين نصحاء وأصلح اللهم حال الأهل ويسر اللهم جمع الشمل يا ربي وافتح فتحك المبينة لمن تولى وأعز الدين وانصره يا ذا الطول وانصر حزبه واملأ بما يرضيك عنه قلبه يا ربي وانصر نصرك محمد واجعل ختام عزه كما بدي واحفظه يا ربي بحفظ العلماء وارفع منار نوره إلى السماء واعفي وعافي واكفي واغفر ذنبنا وذنب كل مسلمين يا ربنا وصلي يا ربي على المختار صلاتك الكاملة المقدار صلاتك التي تفي بأمره كما يليق بارتفاع قدره ثم صلى الآل الكرام وعلى أصحابه الغر ومن لهم تلا والحمد لله الذي بحمده يبلغ ذو القصد تمام قصده
الفاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.